लर्न ग्रामर एडवर्ब क्लॉजेस. एडवर्ब क्लॉज. एन एडवर्ब क्लॉज इज अ सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज दैट फंक्शंस एज एन एडवर्ब. इट मॉडिफाइज अ वर्ब एन एडजेक्टिव और अनदर एडवर्ब. The adverb clause begin with the subordinating conjunction when, where, because, since, as, so that, if, unless, though, although, etc. Let us understand adverb clauses with the help of the following example. The first sentence, the child cried when it saw a dog. This is also a clause, or this sentence has a main clause and a subordinate clause. The subordinating conjunction when, which is highlighted in yellow. From the subordinating conjunction begins the subordinate clause. And adverb clauses begin with the subordinating conjunction when. So, when it saw a dog is the subordinate adverb clause. The child cried is a main clause. Here, this subordinate adverb clause modifies this verb cried. You ask the question, cried when it saw a dog. The second sentence, the wind blows where it likes. Again, where is the subordinating conjunction? From the subordinating conjunction begins the subordinate clause. This subordinate clause is an adverb clause. We read in the note, the adverb clause begin with the subordinating conjunction where. So, where it likes is the subordinate adverb clause. The main clause is the wind blows. Here also it is modifying a verb, blows. The next sentence, my parents were happy because I stood first in the class. Here again, because is highlighted, it is a subordinating conjunction. From the subordinating conjunction begins the subordinate clause. This subordinate clause, because I stood first in the class, is the subordinate adverb clause. My parents were happy is the main clause. This subordinate adverb clause, because I stood first in the class, modifies this adjective happy. Although he is a very rich man, he is a miser. The subordinating conjunction highlighted in yellow is although. So we know that the subordinating from the subordinating conjunction begins the subordinate clause. So, although he is a very rich man is the subordinate clause. It is a subordinate adverb clause. The note says the adverb clause begin with the subordinating conjunction although. He is a miser is the main clause. In such sentences, when the subordinate clause comes before, how do we identify the main clause? You have to identify the verbs. The first verb here is and the second verb, this verb is. It's the second verb. You take the subject which comes before the second verb and put a stroke. So this sentence from the second verb including the subject is the main clause. Therefore, he is a miser is the main clause. Although he is a very rich man is the subordinate adverb clause. Kinds of adverb clauses. The adverb clause can be classified into 9. The first one, adverb clause of time. Second, adverb clause of place. Third, adverb clause of reason. Fourth, adverb clause of purpose. Fifth, adverb clause of result. Sixth, adverb clause of condition. Seventh, adverb clause of manner. Eighth, adverb clause of comparison. And the ninth adverb clause is adverb clause of concession. So we see that the adverb clauses are classified into 9 types. Adverb clause of time. The first sentence, we will go after the school is over. This is a clause. We have to identify the main clause and the subordinate adverb clause. You see here, after is the subordinating conjunction. It is highlighted in yellow. So from this subordinating conjunction begins the subordinate clause. So after the school is over is the subordinate adverb clause of time. We will go is the main clause. Why is this the adverb clause of time? Because if you ask the question to this verb, will go when, you get the answer after the school is over. So therefore, after the school is over is a subordinate adverb clause of time. And look at this note, the subordinating conjunctions after, while, until, when, and before introduce adverb clause of time. So in this first sentence, we see that the subordinating conjunction after has introduced subordinate adverb clause of time. Also, when you ask the question when after the verb and you get the answer, then it is the adverb clause of time. The second sentence, my mother washed my clothes while I went to the market. Again, you see while is highlighted in yellow. Here, while, it is a subordinating conjunction introducing adverb clause of time. Therefore, while I went to the market is the subordinate adverb clause of time. My mother washed my clothes is the main clause. You ask the question to this verb, washed when, while I went to the market. So therefore, while I went to the market is this adverb clause or the subordinate adverb clause of time. The third sentence, she can't come out until the time is over. Until is highlighted, it is the subordinating conjunction introducing adverb clause of time. So, until the time is over is the subordinate adverb clause of time. She can't come out is the main clause. You ask the question, can't come. Come out when? Until the time is over. The fourth sentence, the girl shouted when she saw the snake. Again, when is highlighted in yellow. It is a subordinating conjunction introducing subordinate adverb clause of time. So, when she saw the snake is the subordinate adverb clause of time and the girl shouted is the main clause. The fifth sentence, you can't see before you have dusted it. Again, before is highlighted. It is a subordinating conjunction introducing adverb clause of time. So, before you have dusted it is the subordinate adverb clause of time and you can't see is the main clause. And you can see here, children, that everything in red is the main clause and everything in blue is the subordinate adverb clause of time. And the subordinating conjunctions are highlighted in yellow. Adverb clause of place. Let us identify the adverb clause of place with the help of the following examples. The first sentence or the first clause, the girls went where they could chat. Here in this sentence, we have to identify the main clause and the subordinate clause. This word where is the subordinating conjunction. From the subordinating conjunction begins the subordinate clause. Where they could chat is the subordinate adverb clause of place. The girls went is the main clause. You ask the question to this verb, went where they could chat. When you get the answer, then you should know that it is a subordinate adverb clause of place. The second sentence, wherever I go, you are my companion. Again, wherever is the subordinating conjunction. From the subordinating conjunction begins the subordinate clause. Wherever I go is the subordinate adverb clause of place. You are my companion is the main clause. In such a sentence, when the subordinate clause comes before the main clause, how do we identify the main clause? You have to first underline the verbs. The first verb is go here and the second verb is are. From the second verb, including the subject, you is the subject here, will be your main clause. So, you are my companion becomes the main clause. Wherever I go is the subordinate adverb clause of place. Here also in these two examples, in red is the main clause and in blue is the subordinate adverb clause of place. Adverb clause of place answers the question where. The subordinating conjunctions that introduce adverb clause of place, where, wherever. adverb clause of reason. Let us identify the adverb clause of reason with the help of the following examples. The first sentence, he was angry because no one had helped him. In this sentence, we have to identify the main clause and the subordinate adverb clause of reason. Because is the subordinating conjunction. From the subordinating conjunction begins the subordinate clause. So, because no one had helped him is the subordinate adverb clause of reason. Look at the note. The subordinating conjunctions because, since, that and as introduce adverb clause of reason. So therefore, because no one had helped him is the subordinate adverb clause of reason. Also, when you ask the question why to the verb or to the adjective or to the adverb and you get the answer, then it becomes an adverb clause of reason. In this case, he was angry. Angry, why? Because no one had helped him. The second sentence, the proposal fell through since no one seconded it. Again, since is the subordinating conjunction. Subordinating conjunctions introduce subordinate clause. This subordinating conjunction since introduces adverb clause of reason. Therefore, since no one seconded it is the subordinate adverb clause of reason. The proposal fell through is the main clause. You ask the question, fell, why? Since no one seconded it. The third sentence, I was very glad that mother liked my idea. Yet again, that is highlighted in yellow. It is the subordinating conjunction that has introduced adverb clause of reason. Therefore, that mother liked my idea is a subordinate adverb clause of reason. I was very glad is the main clause. The next sentence, as she had to work late at the office, she couldn't come for the party. As is the subordinating conjunction, it introduces subordinate adverb clause of reason. Therefore, as she had to work late at the office is the subordinate adverb clause of reason. She couldn't come for the party is the main clause. In this sentence, the subordinate clause has come before the main clause. So, in such a case, when you have to identify the main clause, you have to underline the verbs. The first verb is had to work and the second verb is couldn't come. Where the second verb is, you will include the subject which comes before the second verb and you put a stroke before it. So you have to put a stroke before she. She couldn't come for the party becomes the main clause. As she had to work late at the office is the subordinate adverb clause of reason. I'm reading the note once again. The subordinating conjunctions because, since, that and as introduce adverb clause of reason. Adverb clause of purpose. Let us identify the adverb clause of purpose with the help of the following examples. The first sentence, they set out very early in order that they could reach their village before sunset. In order that is highlighted, it is the subordinating conjunction. Look at the note, adverb clause of purpose are introduced by so that, in order that. So here it is in order that. This subordinating conjunction introduces adverb clause of purpose. From this subordinating conjunction begins the subordinate clause. In order that they could reach their village before sunset becomes the subordinate adverb clause of purpose. And the main clause is they set out very early. The next sentence, finish your work early so that you get sufficient time to sleep. Look at the note once again. Adverb clause of purpose are introduced by so that. So from this subordinating conjunction, so that begins the subordinate clause. So that you get sufficient time to sleep is the subordinate adverb clause of purpose. Finish your work early is the main clause. Adverb clause of purpose are introduced by so that, in order that. The main clause is in red and the subordinate adverb clause of purpose is in blue. Adverb clause of result. Let us identify the adverb clause of result with the help of the following examples. We shall first read the note. Adverb clause of result is introduced by so that. The word so figures in the main clause and is balanced with that in the subordinate clause. Adverb clause of result express the result of some action mentioned in the main clause. Let us understand this note with the help of the following examples. Adverb clause of result is introduced by so that. So appears in the main clause and that is in the subordinate clause. So which is the main clause? The thief was so cunning. That no one could identify is the subordinate adverb clause of result. The subordinating conjunction is so that. But so will figure in the main clause. See, the main clause is written in red. And that figures in the subordinate clause, which is in blue. That no one could identify him is the subordinate adverb clause of result. The note also says that adverb clause of result express the result of some action mentioned in the main clause. The action of the thief being cunning. Because he was cunning, no one could identify. The result was that no one could identify him. The second sentence, the painting was so beautiful that everyone admired it. Again, the conjunction that introduces adverb clause of result is so that. But so figures or appears in the main clause and that appears in the subordinate clause. The painting was so beautiful, main clause. It is written in red that everyone admired it, subordinate adverb clause of result. Adverb clause of result express the result of some action mentioned in the main clause. So because the painting was beautiful, everyone admired it. The result was that everyone admired it. Adverb clause of condition. Let us identify the adverb clause of condition in the following sentences. Note, the subordinate conjunctions if and unless introduce adverb clause of condition. You see this, unless is highlighted here and if. The first sentence, the crops will fail unless it rains this week. Unless is the subordinate conjunction, it introduces the adverb clause of condition. So, unless it rains this week is the subordinate adverb clause of condition. The crops will fail is the main clause. The second sentence, if war breaks out, no city in the world will be safe. Here again, if is the subordinate conjunction. From the subordinate conjunction begins the subordinate clause. If war breaks out is the subordinate adverb clause of condition. No city in the world will be safe is the main clause. In such a sentence, when the subordinate clause comes before the main clause, we have to identify the verbs also. So the first verb is breaks. The second verb is will be safe. Where the second verb is, you include the subject. In this sentence, no city in the world is the subject. So from this subject, no city in the world will be still will be safe will be your main clause. If war breaks out is the subordinate adverb clause of condition. I'll read the note again. The subordinate conjunctions if and unless introduce adverb clause of condition. Adverb clause of manner. Let us identify the adverb clause of manner in the following sentences. Note, the adverb clause of manner are introduced by the relative adverb as. The first sentence, the story ended as I had guessed. So as is highlighted, it is the relative adverb. It introduces the subordinate clause, the subordinate adverb clause of manner. Therefore, as I had guessed is the subordinate adverb clause of manner. The story ended is the main clause. To identify adverb clause of manner, you ask the question how to the verb. In the lower classes, you learnt about adverb of manner. To find out adverb of manner, you ask the question how. So here also you will ask the question, how did this verb ended? The story ended how? As I had guessed. Therefore, as I had guessed is the adverb clause of manner or subordinate adverb clause of manner. The next sentence, the sea raged as it was forecast. Again, as is highlighted, it is the relative adverb. It introduces the subordinate adverb clause of manner. As it was forecast, subordinate adverb clause of manner, the sea raged is the main clause. Again, you ask the question, the sea raged how? As it was forecast. So you get the answer. Therefore, as it was forecast is the subordinate adverb clause of manner. I'll read the note again. The adverb clause of manner are introduced by the relative adverb as. Adverb clause of comparison. Adverb clause of comparison are introduced by the conjunctions than and as. Let us understand adverb clause of comparison with the help of the following examples. The first sentence, lack of unity is a bigger danger to freedom than any outside threat. Here, than is highlighted in yellow. It is a conjunction that has introduced adverb clause of comparison. Therefore, than any outside threat is the subordinate adverb clause of comparison. Lack of unity is a bigger danger to freedom is the main clause. The next sentence, Sanjana speaks as well as her mother does. Here, as is highlighted, it is the conjunction which introduces adverb clause of comparison. Therefore, as well as her mother does is the subordinate adverb clause of comparison. Sanjana speaks is the main clause. Adverb clause of concession. Note, adverb clause of concession are introduced by the subordinating conjunctions though, although. Let us understand adverb clause of concession with the help of the following examples. Although he knew the answer, he did not write. Here, although is highlighted in yellow, it is a subordinating conjunction that introduces adverb clause of concession. And we know that from the subordinating conjunction begins the subordinate clause. Therefore, although he knew the answer is the subordinate adverb clause of concession. He did not write is the main clause. Here again, the subordinate clause comes before the main clause. So what do? We identify the verb. The first verb is knew and the second verb is did. Did not write. So you take the subject before the second verb and put a stroke before it. So the subject and the second verb and the remaining part of the sentence becomes the main clause. He did not write will be the main clause. Although he knew the answer is the subordinate adverb clause of concession. The next sentence, he was a man of great courage, though he had no physical strength. Again, though is highlighted in yellow. It is the subordinating conjunction introducing adverb clause of concession. And we know that from the subordinating conjunction begins the subordinate clause. Therefore, though he had no physical strength is the subordinate adverb clause of concession. He was a man of great courage is the main clause.